Filipino-Chinese business groups donate funds for relief efforts in typhoon-hit areas. Almost 1 million pesos worth of cash assistance has been raised in the donation drive. The initiative was led by the Anvil Business Club, participated by organizations such as the Tu Chi Foundation. They say this is just the first of a series of donations to help victims rebuild their lives after their homes and livelihood were devastated by Typhoon Odette.
We still have donations coming in as we speak. So once we get more allocations, we will identify some more partners and organizations that would help us distribute. All Anvil wants right now is to for our friends in the South to have a good Christmas man lang. No? So as much as we can, we want them to we want to be able to help in our own way.
The Philippine Coast Guard also chipping in to help the victims of Odette. Members of the PCG District, Western Visayas, used their own money to buy nearly 100 gallons of drinking water for affected families in Cebu. This as access to clean water remains a problem in Cebu and other typhoon-hit areas. Meanwhile, a Coast Guard ship has also delivered 2,000 liters of gasoline and 16 portable generator sets to Cebu.
More countries are sending donations to fast-track recovery efforts in typhoon-hit areas. Canada has allocated $50,000 Canadian as an initial response to the most affected communities in the Caraga region. The funding will facilitate the delivery of much-needed humanitarian aid. The Embassy of Israel, meanwhile, has sent food packs, hygiene kits, and water purifiers to victims of Typhoon Odette in Bohol and Cebu. Solar energy systems were also sent to typhoon-hit residents. The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines says it has restored around 70 to 75% of the 95 transmission lines affected by Typhoon Odette. It says the storm damaged over 12 transmission towers and over 600 transmission poles in Visayas and Mindanao. It stresses the importance of local governments supporting its transmission projects.
And I'd really like to take this opportunity to explain why NGCP's transmission projects are important and that the local government officials should support this. Because, you know, we've been trying to finish these projects, but we are there are difficulties with the at the local level. So if should these interconnection and looping projects have pushed through on time, then there would have been redundancies and alternative paths, and restoration would be easy.
Meanwhile, the Energy Regulatory Commission orders power industry players to fast-track the restoration of their services in typhoon-hit areas. It also instructed power utility companies and electric cooperatives to relax payment collection rules for customers affected by the typhoon.
Kasama doon sa i-direct namin sa mga distribution utilities na pag-relax sa kanilang collection policy ay siyempre yung hindi muna pagpapatupad ng agad-agarang disconnection sa mga kababayan natin na naapektuhan ng bagyo na hindi makakabayad on time.
More updates now on typhoon relief efforts at Chacon, Palawan, where the situation in some areas remains dire. We'll be speaking to Provincial Information Officer Attorney Christian J. Cuhamco. Attorney, good afternoon.
Yes, sir, Ron. Good afternoon.
Attorney, it's nice that we were able to contact you. We do want to know the situation in Palawan. It's been a couple of days since Odette wreaked havoc there, and we've seen photos and videos of the destruction wrought by the typhoon. Tell us how it is looking now.
Well, sir Ron, the situation now here is better. We are now conducting continuous repacking of our family food box for distribution to our northern municipalities. And the power, the electricity here is already online. The Globe and PLDT signal, as well as the smart signal, is also back online. And now we are on the process of assessing the damage here in our province.
Now, in the past days, there were still reports of roads that remain impassable. Are there still areas that have not received aid yet because of that?
Yes, Sir Ron, as of the moment, we already have removed the landslide and repaired all the bridges. So the land travel from Puerto Princesa City to the northern municipalities are now possible.
That is good to know. You did say that electricity and communication lines, some of them have been restored. How about water supply?
The water supply here in Puerto Princesa is also back. However, we are having problems with our northern municipalities since our water filtration projects in our northern municipalities have been damaged by the Typhoon Odette. So we are appealing for the national government for help to send us water filtration, a portable water filtration system in order to avoid sickness in our evacuation centers.
Okay, we do want to get the casualty count as well. How many have been reported dead in the wake of Odette and how many are still missing?
Sir Ron, as of the moment, we already have 34 casualties, but when we say casualties here, it involves injured and rescued individuals. So out of the 34 casualties, we already have rescued 17. Three of them are from Rojas, Palawan. Then are from San Vicente, two are from Aborlan, and two are from the island municipality of Araceli. But we still are looking for 10 more individuals. We have 10 more missing persons, and our fatalities is already up to 7 individuals.
Okay, thank you very much for the data. Most of the areas affected by the typhoon and that ANC has talked to are worried about their funds. Does Palawan still have funds to help its residents, sir?
Yes, Sir Ron. Yesterday, the declaration of the resolution for the declaration of state of calamity in Palawan has already been approved by our acting governor. And because of that, we already have access to our calamity fund amounting to 36.4 million. However, this amount would not be sufficient in order to help our affected constituents to come back on their foot. So we are still appealing for additional funds from the national government and from NGOs.
And that appeal has already been sent to the national government. When are you expecting a reply?
I'm sorry, Sir Ron. Can you come again?
Yes, you said that you appealed for more funds from the national government. When are you expecting a reply to that, if they are going to add more funds, attorney?
Yes, Sir Ron, yesterday we already conferred with the regional director of the SWD as well as with the regional director of the civil defense, and they already sent us additional food packs, but and also the SWD committed to send us additional blankets, clothes, and clean water. So, however, again, the numbers would still not be enough because as of the moment, we already have 20,779 affected families and 12,000 of them are still in the evacuation centers.
Right, I was just about to ask that, sir. How many evacuation centers have been set up for those families, sir, and how are they doing right now?
Sir, in our northern municipalities, we have more or less 50 evacuation centers catering to 12,000 families. That's more or less 19,000 individuals. So as of the moment, we already have enough supply for good for 3 days, and still we are here in from the provincial capital. We are continuously repacking family food packs to be sent there. The road to the northern municipalities had just been opened this afternoon, so we are now looking for faster transportation of these family food packs.
Now, attorney, those people in evacuation centers, most of them, if not all, have already lost their homes. due to Odette. How is Palawan planning to help them in rebuilding their homes and even their lives and helping them get back to their feet?
Yes, Sir Ron, we are now looking for any available funds from the provincial government. And we are looking at giving them financial assistance for them to acquire, to buy supplies to rebuild their home. But as of now, we just want them to have like a portable tent so they can have some sense of privacy while they are in the evacuation centers.
Attorney Kohamko, how is the security situation there as well? Have there been reports of looting in the area?
Yes, Sir Ron, we are very thankful that the Palawenos still remain upright even in the midst of this calamity. There are no reports of looting. There are no reports of crimes as of the moment, Sir Ron.
Okay, just a couple of quick questions more. The government is still seeking to fast-track vaccination nationwide, attorney. We know that Palawan is dealing with a lot of problems there right now, but would you know when the vaccination can resume there?
Yes, Sir Ron, our vaccination efforts are still ongoing despite the typhoon event, and now we are looking at giving the second dose so we can reach up to 40% of our target for the herd immunity.
That's good to know that it's continuing. Have there been any reports of any COVID vaccine wastage? Any of the vaccine vials damaged?
Yes, Sir Ron, the provincial health office, our provincial health office just reported that there has been 500 doses of Sputnik 5 wastage. So this is because of the outage of our electricity here. The vaccine has been thawed for more than 2 hours. So that's 500, if I'm not mistaken, 500 vials of Sputnik 5.
Okay, Attorney Christian J. Kohamko of the Palawan Provincial Information Office. Attorney Kohamko, maraming salamat po. Ingat po kayo dyan.
Thank you so much, Sir Ron, and keep safe.
Latest government data show the Philippines' agriculture sector suffered more than 3 billion pesos worth of damage due to Typhoon Odette. The Agriculture Department says rice production sectors absorbed the biggest hit, around 1.7 billion pesos worth of damage, while the fishing industry suffered at least 1.3 billion pesos in losses. It also says almost 40,000 farmers and fishers have been affected by the storm. The agency expects the cost of damage to further rise in the coming days.